Welcome to Swashbuckling with Code. I'm Jimmy Cleveland, and in this video, we're going to be delving into a little bit of GraphQL with Gatsby, as well as the Gatsby source file system, because I think that's kind of where the rubber meets the road, so to speak, when you kind of start getting into the GraphQL parts of Gatsby, which is really what makes it very cool. So in the previous video, we built a Gatsby site from scratch, and so I'm going to be using that as a reference. I'll have a link to that in case you want to watch that. But it's a pretty simple one, and I'll really roughly go through it. So if you just want to start here, that's cool too. Now, the point of these videos to me is that I don't want to just show like what would effectively be me going through the docs and just printing out and pasting and saying, this is how you do a thing. I want to take a more of a step-by-step approach because I think a lot of people are kind of there's a little bit of magic behind the scenes in Gatsby for them. And while I'm not going to get like a mega deep dive, I at least want to take more of a step-by-step approach and walk you through like the parts that are going on. So hopefully you can know a little bit more about how you can control how your data works and set up your site in Gatsby. So let's jump into that. Let's start with a brief recap on what we did last time. Okay. So we have this Gatsby project. It's very minimal, and I think it makes the most sense to probably start from the data viewpoint. So the data itself is a simple array of objects, which has a few keys with some values. And so we're not using GraphQL yet, but obviously in this video we're going to. But at this point we take the data.js and we're going to import that into Gatsby node right here. And then we use the create pages API to loop over that data and create a page for each item in it. And we are the required things here are the path and component. We've created this component to send it on over to, and we're going to send some context as we do, which is just data we want to look up. If we go to that component, page context pulled off of props is how we can access it. And then we simply just spit those values out. It's pretty straightforward. So next we want to start looking into delving into GraphQL and importing some of our file system into GraphQL, because that's where Gatsby really starts to be awesome. So we'll do yarn develop. And then while we're doing that, show you that if you do add markdown to Gatsby or something like that, you search for that, you'll find a few different posts. They've changed over the time frame that I've been using it, but let's just go to this one and see what happens. So this will walk you through setting up Gatsby source file system, and eventually we're going to obviously move on to doing some markdown pages, but for this video we're going to center around this because I think it's a good introduction to GraphQL under the hood and what's going on with the source file system. I feel like a lot of people just kind of gloss over this part, so I'm going to cover it. Okay, so this our server should be up and running now. We have the home page, and for a quick refresher, the home page is not created dynamically or generated content. It's just a static thing, and this is how Gatsby lets you handle pages that you just want to kind of manually make if you put anything under this pages directory. Okay. But if we go to just some gibberish URL, it'll take us to the 404 page, and we can see that we have this first and second from our data, and it loads those two, okay? It's pretty cool, but now we want to add a Gatsby source file system. So I'll just copy that so I don't have any lovely typos. Then we pop on over to here, our terminal, close the server down, and add it, Gatsby source file system. That should only take a moment. And then we're going to do yarn develop. Might as well just start it up again. And we don't need this anymore. And for now, we don't need this. Okay, so the thing that we're going to need now, though, is a Gatsby config, which we haven't needed up until this point. And that's what's kind of cool, is Gatsby just kind of lets you add these things as you need them. But most projects do have this. Now, the way that Gatsby config works, and that name does have to be exact there, of course. You just do the standard node module.exports, and you're going to export an object with some keys on it. Now, the most common one you're going to do is plugins. In on this plugins, you can either pass in a plugin by just a string, or you can pass it in as an object if you have extra options too, which is what we need to do here. So when you do an object, you have to do resolve. And when you want to resolve that, let's see if I still have that, you just name the plugin that we just installed. And then they're usually going to take options. And the way that this kind of works under the hood is these options are passed up to that plugin. And then that's just normally pulled off of the function that's called to call that plugin. And then they can handle those options however they like. So path is what we really need. So what we're going to do is use, this is pretty common for them to do, and I'm pretty sure they're going to do in, let's go over here. Yeah, dirname. There you go. So just a real quick intro to dirname if you aren't familiar with it, or if you kind of get that confused with path.resolve, which you used previously. Dirname is just a way to say, what's the directory for the file that I'm currently running in? So we're saying from here, because different operating systems, you know, have different directory structures and all that, we're going to go to source, and I'm going to make a data folder here. Okay, so I'm going to make that right now, just a generic one. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my data up here and move it. I'm just going to say yes to the import update for now. And then I'm going to rename that to page data to not just be data data. Not that it's the greatest name in the world, but it'll do. And that's just going to make me resave this file. And you can see that I updated my import path. So everything should still be working at this point. So now what we're doing is we've told Gatsby on build time to start looking into this directory. And if we pop over to our terminal, we'll see that it's updating as we do that. But now it says the develop process needs to be restarted. So we'll do that. Every now and then, you do have to do that. They've gotten better and better as updates have come out with Gatsby to let you just leave the development server running, and it'll try to restart as best as it can. But every now and then, you still need to. So now let's also just make a new file, and I'm just going to make a like first. Let's just do it first.md, and then we'll do like an ID, and we'll say first page, and then we'll say this is the first page or something stupid to get some text in here. And then we could make really any file we want. We could make a woof.txt, and this has, you know, woof, just a bunch of dumb stuff in it. And then when we come over to here, you'll notice that when we started this server up, we also, in addition to our normal URL up here, we have this GraphQL URL. And so if we come over here, well, let's just pop it in here, open that up. And this gives you this nice graphical user interface, which is a very clever name by them, GraphQL. So when we open GraphQL, what it is it's a GUI for querying and looking at what all of your schema for GraphQL is. So over on the side, this is relatively newer. This didn't used to exist when I first started using it, and it's super cool and one of the killer features of it. It lets you see all the different types that are in your system, and you'll see that we have a file type. So if we go to file and we scroll down here, we have all these like purple names, which I'm going to come back to, and then we have all these blue names, and I should probably bump this up a couple steps for you. So down here, you'll see that there's this public URL, there's a relative path, there's an absolute path, there's all this like file system type information, ext and extension. You know, you can just kind of check things, and it's building this query as you go on the side. And so as soon as you hit this play button, it's going to make that query, and you'll see that it gave us all of these properties. It's really cool. Another way to see some of this information is GraphQL kind of has this like auto documentation generated through this graphical interface, and you can do it with other ones. But let's say we were to search for file, you can see that file is a type. And when you click on it, it goes through and it tells you all of the properties and what kind of variable type they are. So in this case, this is a string, and the bang means that it's required for that type. And you can see all sorts of stuff. And it's really cool. So coming back to this, notice that we only got one result. But we had multiple files in there, right? Well, that's because we are querying for a single thing, but we didn't like tell it which one we want. So it's going to grab the first one, which is kind of nice for it to do. But that's where all these all versions of the ones that exist down here come into play. So Gatsby, the way that it does this, or its way that it elects to do it, is take all of the entries for a type, call it all that type, so all file, and then you can think of edges as sort of like the array of those things, and then each one of those objects is a node. And if you come down here, you'll see that we have all the same information now. So we do have absolute path again, ext, and extension. If we query that, it's going to see how it gives us this array as edges, and then an array of objects with node on them. Okay. Yeah, so you can see that ext just has the dot in front of the extension, whereas the other one doesn't, because that might just be useful when you're trying to sort through data. I'm sure they have a reason for putting that on there. And then you can see that we have this markdown file, and you can see that we have this txt file. So it's grabbed everything in that directory and pulled it into GraphQL, and that is pretty cool. And this is just the first step to just having full control over the data in your site and being able to get really in-depth under the hood and do all sorts of cool stuff with how you want to query things or sort and filter, or if you need to like create files or create pages, which we're going to do in the next video. So I think that is a good quick summary, hopefully, for just GraphQL using the source plugin for the file system in Gatsby. And in the next video, we're going to take some of this markdown and we're going to use a transformer and transform this into more GraphQL data from just a simple file, since this doesn't give us everything we need to build it from markdown, and show all the cool stuff that gives us and how you can have some control over generating your pages from markdown.